to the final, which was played in front of 9,000 fans at Wembley Arena. It was between the defending champions, the Worthing Bears. They were up against the Guildford Kings. And for Worthing, well, their team includes the player coach and former Harlem Globetrotter Alan Cunningham in what is his farewell appearance in the sport. And also Colin Irish, who was their highest scorer in the semi-final with 18 points. For the Guildford Kings, Alton Bird, probably the most influential figure in British basketball during the 80s, is a key member of their team. The Kings also include British internationals Carl Miller, Martin Henlon and Carl Brown, who was their top scorer in the semi-finals with 19 points. Well, we can join it at the halfway point, the start of the third quarter, with the defending champions Worthing Bears in trouble. They're trailing 34-27.
So the second half, the third quarter, about to get underway. 34-27 Guildford lead. Their biggest lead was 11. They haven't actually, Worthing haven't been in the lead since the sixth minute of the first quarter. Cummings, the top scorer for Guildford, 8 points. He's also got 6 rebounds. He scored those points early. Henlon gets into position, the right place at the right time, and a most emphatic 2 points to the big man.
What a way to start the second half of championship basketball. Nice tip down to Alton Bird and a beautiful inside pass to Martin Henlon. Great start for Guildford.
Good rebound by Henlon. Harriet couldn't quite get inside. Bird, everyone rushing back. Oh, he almost got that pass in. Such disguise and speed. Now, Lewis. Lewis looking to go himself, opting to Cunningham as coach for assistance. Cunningham moving inside. Over the top of Henlon. That was good play by Alan Cunningham. 8 points to him. Incidentally, Cunningham 6 rebounds in the first half. The overall scoring, or shooting rather, Guildford 14 from 30, that's from two-point range in the first half, 2 from 5, three-point range. But the interesting statistic, after telling you that Worthing had hit 12 from 30 from two-point range, 2 from 9 three-pointers they hit in that first half, and that's a telling statistic.
It's a poor one for them because they don't need to do that. They're such a tall, powerful team that really they should play the basketball inside. There's an example there where Worthing work the offense, go inside, power the way to the basket and draw the fouls against Guildford, which means easy points from the foul line.
Have a look again. The inside movement this time. We were just making that point. The higher potential and higher probability shot, certainly important now as far as Worthing are concerned. They're 5 points down, 4 points down now, so they're still absolutely in it. It's a very, very close encounter of the first kind, this. Bird calls the play. This is one of the set patterns, and it's freed Cummings. Cummings has it now. Defended by Irish. Bird gets inside. Good rebound there by Lewis. And Guildford very quick to respond in defensive terms, aren't they? Bird coming forward looking, defending on Lewis. Oh, say.
Great move by Cleve Lewis. He's taken advantage of the fact he's 6'6", Alton Bird's about 5'8", and if he can create some space, he can take Alton to the basket and power his way over the top of him.
Well, Brown and Bird distributing the ball from the high position at the moment, and when they go inside, it collapses that defence. Cunningham is also playing well inside, quietly and effectively. He's rebounding very nicely indeed. 7 rebounds is tally overall. So, Cunningham defended by Miller. Bird and Lewis, the matchup. And that was a bit of freedom. There must be a foul there somewhere. Now, Alan Cunningham, offensive foul. The coach being pushed away just a few shots. Wanted to go and have a word with the referee, but Colin Irish thinks perhaps not. And that's one of the difficulties of being coach and a player.
I think he's got some real difficulties, Alan Cunningham. you know, he's at the end of his playing days, and his energy level mustn't be as high as usual. He's the key player, he's also the coach. All those things compounding together in a championship final, very difficult to handle.
It's 7-2 to Worthing in this third quarter. Henlon looks to inside. Got a second chance. Harriet couldn't quite control the ball. But Cunningham, now an England international, actually made his England debut at the age of 38. He's now 39. Gives many people hope, I guess. Bird. Lovely little bounce pass inside to Henlon. Henlon gets a second shot. Doesn't quite make it.
Worthing doing an absolutely wonderful job against Martin Henlon on defence. They're surrounding him with three or four, with four equally tall players, and Martin does not get the space and time to get those easy shots away. Good play by Worthing.
Henlon's hit 2 out of 9, incidentally. So he has been put under tremendous pressure. Now, what can Irish do? Got a rebound, did Henlon there, and Bird under attention of Cunningham. Bird and Cunningham played together, of course, the old Kingston side. Oh, that was nice from Brown.
That's the answer for Guildford. The way to beat power and size is to be quick. And to be quick down the court with Alton Bird means that if you get open, you will get the ball, and Guildford would score those easy baskets.
Guildford only 4 points in 4 minutes, according to John Quinlan, our statistician. Just keeping count of such things. Lovely. Now, all of a sudden, it's opened up. Cummings gets two. There was a big gap, and the fast break option taken. It's always the first option, of course. So Nelson brings it down, and Cunningham tucked away in the corner, defended by Miller. Cunningham, good rebound by Harrod. It certainly was. And Bird trying to dislodge that ball from a much taller opponent. And it's Alton Bird's foul. Remember, let's remind you, Bird is what? 5'8" today. And Harrod, 6'7". So there's a mismatch in height, and Bird the man to foul. Substitutions coming. Brown and Henlon on the bench. Polity has gone on. And number 8 for Guildford, Clive Harriott for the moment. They have a foul. It's number 11 again. That's Adrian Cummings gets his third foul in that affray. There's the newcomer, Clive Harriott. Big improver this year. Actually, he's a former 400-meter runner at North Carolina University in America. He was on a scholarship as an athlete, but certainly enjoying his basketball. This Cummings, 34-40, as you see. So 6 points between these sides, 5:16 to go in the third quarter. Irish, defended by Harriott. Harriott with fresh legs, putting a lot of pressure on. And once again, one of those shots that you wouldn't expect from a player of that experience. Harriott tripping Henlon off your shot, the crowd realising it, but the rest of the crowd realising that two more points have gone in. And Cummings, the man responsible, 42-34, 12 points his personal tally, 4:50 to go, third quarter.
And Guildford's speed proving decisive at the moment. Worthing are going to have to be careful to make the right shot selection. The last shot by Colin Irish was really very, very forced. Guildford won the rebound, came down the court, made the basket. So Worthing are now going to have to take shots just like that. Steve Nelson, balanced, composed, firing a very good three-pointer.
Was indeed. Bird, a lovely assist to Henlon, and Harrod fouling him. And Harrod and Cunningham remonstrating with each other. So, third foul. So, Henlon. Two shots for him. Big Martin Henlon, 27, 6'10" tall. Alton Bird taking a break. Baker out there again now. Ronnie Baker, 5'9", formerly with Brixton and London. He's out there, the speedster. So Henlon, yes. Injured this season, missed half of the season, in fact, and was certainly their best player in European competition was Henland. 2 from 3, 66% his statistics so far, as you saw. And this Nelson breaking away, Irish getting through past Miller and getting 2 points. Well, it's still wide open, isn't it? With 4 minutes and 8 seconds to go in the third quarter, it's 43-39.
Both teams playing man-to-man. Politi there showing a nice little move. Fakes, draws his defender, skips around him. Nice jump shot.
9 points to Julio Politi, Argentinian-born player. He is a useful player. Big outside shooter, as we've said several times. He's demonstrated it several times, too. And that's a foul by Baker on Cunningham. Cadle must be happy with the way things are going at the moment. His team's had the lead pretty well throughout. And I began this quarter by saying, and I'll just remind you of the fact, that Worthing haven't been in the lead since the 6 minute of the first quarter, so there's still a little bit of time, a little bit of work for them to do. Quality defending Lewis. Pass almost cut out, that was lovely from Harrod. Harrod getting inside over Henland. It was a lovely piece of play. He had to take it on the left hand, he had to hook it in to get past Henland.
I've been amazed they've not got the ball more inside to him, and Harrod is player of the year. Excellent player, tall, very athletic, and that was an example of beautiful basketball from him.
Nothing called, and Harrod again showed some good skills, and that was a lovely assist from Harrod. And Irish now, it's 45-43, 2:59. It's very, very close now with 2:56 to go.
And haven't we seen it before? Alton Bird leaves the court for Guildford and the rhythm of the game changes and all of a sudden Worthing look good.
Well, just 2:45 to the end of this third quarter. Now, what can Miller do? Henland inside, defended by Harrod. Henland tries to reciprocate, can't. Lewis. Cunningham in the corner. Looks to get in a little closer. Irish didn't quite get it this time, and the battle of the rebound that time won by Henland. Baker tries to collapse the defence by moving so quickly. Off the mark over the first 5 or 6 metres. He's so quick. And he's got the three-pointer away. It doesn't make it, as you see, but that was quite nice. Miller, and Miller's lost possession again. I think he's retrieved it, he has. Good play. 23 seconds on the shot clock, so there's still time. So they'll try and free Politi on the far side, I would think. He's going behind the screen, yes. Henland, though, moves inside. Is that a travelling violation? I think it is.
Martin Henland's such a great player, but he's frustrated. Worthing have really defended against him very well. One man in close attention, one man all ready to cover. And it's forced Martin into change his normal pattern of movement, and there it forces the error.
Henland's statistics are 2 out of 10 overall, so they're not looking good, although he is a big man in the rebound department at the moment. Now Irish. There's a foul, I think. Is that against Baker? I think it is. Yes, the little man. They're coming a quick look up at the scoreboard. He'll see that there's 1 minute and 21 seconds left in this third quarter. It's 45-43. Guildford still in the lead, just.
And Worthing doing the right thing now. They're moving the ball, penetrating, and getting the ball inside close to the basket. That's where those extra inches count. The tall men can force their way up to the hoop, score those high percentage shots.
Henland incidentally has 8 rebounds, just to bring you up to date on the full story on him. Harrod on the top, looking to get inside. Baker's been substituted, so is Politi. Oh, and that was a bad miss by Harrod. He was there, wasn't he? It was a good pass. A superb assist coming in from Steve Nelson, but Harrod just couldn't hold it. Alton Bird out there again. Just for some control, you see. He's the man that controls the play. We've got a cliche about him. We call him the mid-court general. He really is. Once he's there, he dominates. He controls the whole pattern of play. Watch him. Lovely pass. It was the speed of the pass, not just the direction that takes the defences on the wrong foot. look at that, for an assist into Henlon, and Henlon couldn't quite pull it off, and that's another one he's missed. Offensively, Martin Henlon not having a good time in this third quarter. Just 26 seconds left.
Worthing now will set an offense to run the clock down and then go inside for this big last shot of the quarter.
Worthing 16-9 up in this third quarter, and that turnover, not the sort of thing that was wanted. And certainly Kevin Cadle calling in Henlon, wants to have a little chat.
That's a very good substitution. Henlon's not doing too well, but there's only 14 seconds left. They're going to take an outside shot, so he pulls Henlon out and puts Politi in, another shooter. Gives him another shooting option.
There goes the shot. Didn't quite come off. That's it. 45-43 at the end of the third quarter. So the players moving out for the fourth and final quarter of this Budweiser Championship final between Worthing Bears and the Guildford Kings. Worthing, the defending champions, and Guildford in their familiar red strip. Alton Bird out there. Julio Politi, number six. The outside shooter's there. It's just 2 points, 45-43 to Guildford. In fact, Worthing won the last quarter. It's the first one they've won. And they looked a little bit more confident, I must say, with Harrod really providing some tough offense. And Steve Nelson slowing it down to initiate the pattern. Harrod now in high post position, actually matching up with Henlon. Two big, big men. Henlon at 6'10", has a slight height advantage. Harrod has it. Looking to get over the top. Oh, followed in by Cunningham and Irish. All three of them, and they got their just reward, 2 points. 45 points each. And with 9 minutes and 7 seconds to go in this match. What a final. We expected it to be close. And Alton Bird misses a layup. He may rue the day he did that.
Two good examples of the power of Worthing. Here's a fast break for Guildford. 2-on-1. And Julio Politi fouled as he went in for that layup. But two good examples of the power of Worthington at both ends, at Worthing at the both ends of the floor. Tremendous rebounding, and then Alton Bird missing a shot because he was looking for the tall players coming across to block him.
Nelson's third foul there, the number six for Worthing. Worthing, incidentally, was second in the league. Guildford were fourth, so this would turn the league positions over if Guildford could take this. But remember, it's four times winning for this Guildford side. They've developed from the Kingston side. Worthing, the defending champions, looking to retain their title. And just 1 point, 2 points adrift now. Now look at this pressure. Politi putting pressure now onto Cleve Lewis. Lewis can handle that. Nelson takes it. Harrod. But the early pressure certainly creates one or two mistakes, and that's what the play can build up on, or from. Cunningham out on the top. Irish has it. Cunningham now shifting to rebound position. Oh, Irish hits a big one. That's a beautiful shot from Irish. 12 points to him. 47 points each. 6 from 13. His statistics improving. 47 all, 8 minutes and 10 seconds left in this final. The fast break on. Irish takes the big pass, takes the big basket. Two more. And I will have a feeling that Kevin Cadle may well want to stop the rhythm of this by calling a timeout soon. We'll see.
Very important phase for Worthing. And there we saw Alton Bird getting himself in difficulties. And that must be frustration with his offense. Martin Henlon has faded from this game. Alton needs a big man to put the ball into. And Henlon is just making himself difficult to receive the pass and giving Bird all sorts of problems.
Well, he's finding the inlet pass very difficult indeed, and Miller. And that's the clock has wound down. They lost the 30-second shot clock, and so the ball goes the other way, and that's the end, the result of big pressure. So good defensive play.
Well, there's no clearer sign of a team's frustration with its offense than when they take all the 30 seconds they're allowed before they have to shoot, don't take a shot and give the ball back to the other team.
Irish, defended by Cummings. Harrod, a I think it was out of bounds. Yes, it was. Alan Richardson, the referee, indicated that. Substitution, Alton Bird coming off. Carl Brown coming on. And so Bird taking a little bit of a breather here with 7:14 to go in this final. Look at that, 2 points. Worthing, the champions defending last year's title, in the lead just by two. Now that's an important shot. A good rebound too by Lewis. Slows it down, and that's good discipline. Cleve Lewis, Fresno State, Jamaican born, gets it inside to Harrod, an Irish and Harrod, the duo, and Guildford have got to watch it now because they're on the rack. 51-47, and Worthing go into the lead. 6:36 to go in this final. Can they retain their title? Well, Guildford desperate now to get inside, and Henlon fouled by Cunningham, I think. Yes, Cunningham's foul it was. Well, Irish takes a breather. Well, let's just bring you up to date. 6 minutes and 28 seconds to go in this final. As Cunningham's points, 8 and 2 fouls. 51-47 the score in favour of the Worthing Bears. Well, Phil Jones, the referee, along with Alan Richardson, performed well here. Not noticed them, and that's a very good sign.
Well, Kevin Cade will be hoping that these foul shots bring back some of Martin Henlon's motivation and desire, because he has faded from the game, and Guildford need him so badly. Just like Carl Miller there, strong and powerful, they need that more from Martin Henlon.
Well, I have to say that whilst we criticise Carl Miller in the semi-final, he has performed well in the final. He's had some spells of superb play just when it was wanted. 1 point ahead, Worthing. Now they're 3 points ahead because Cunningham's just popped in another two. The coach, 10 points to Cunningham. Now, Polity and Cummings, Henlon out on the top at the moment. Brown, Carl Brown, just calling the plays. Nice use of the C. Screen on the side of that to paint the red area. No way in, though. Once again, with just 3 seconds to go, that has to hurry the shot, and that was another good phase of defence there by Worthing. Look at that for a pass. Harrod again. The basket is good. The basket is good. And that was a superb piece of play.
Great defence from Worthing. Frustrating, very frustrating. And look, win the loose ball. Quick early pass. And Herman Harrod, such a difficult man to stop. So tall and athletic.
Yeah, on the negative side, it was his fourth foul. It was an offensive foul called against Harrod. So there you've got the evidence. 10 points, but that diminishes his defensive capacity just a little bit. He must be very careful when attacking and crashing those boards in future. That was the sort of shot that Guildford needed. Polity has the reputation, showed it there. 55-52, Worthing by three. 5 minutes and four to go in this final. So, Cunningham. Oh, and Cunningham's playing the role of captain, coach and mentor. 12 points, 46%, 6 from 13, but the last two were of vital importance. The timing in the game that matters. Polity gets a second chance, I think. He's fouled. He's fouled.
14 wins.
There's Colin Irish's second foul called there. 57-52. Worthing over Guildford with 4 minutes and 41 to go. Well, there are the points for the various quarters. 14-7 to Worthing in this final quarter. As I said to you, 16-11 in the third quarter. So Worthing in the driving seat. And I wonder what Kevin Cadle has had to say. He heard what Alan Cunningham had to say, but Cadle at the other end had the bigger problem. He's 5 points adrift with just 4:41 to go. It's a long time in basketball terms, but it was the tenor of the game that must have dismayed Kevin Cadle. His team were really without an effective big man in the middle, with Henlon not firing on four cylinders at the moment. He's been very well defended. Now there's an urgency about the Worthing defence as Bird takes a big shot and misses, and that was a disappointment for Guildford. Well picked up by Nelson, and the discipline he showed by just slowing it down. Lewis is there, Cunningham's there, defended by Miller. Cunningham again, Miller not letting him in. Harried his back door. Henlon defending him. And that centre position. Some more good defence here. Politi, just before the shot clock lapsed. Oh, and that was a bad mistake. Two mistakes now by Guildford. Once they've got the ball, they've got to make the attack count, that's for sure. 5 points, they're down.
Worthing have got to play the percentage game now. They've got this slight lead. They go inside to the big men, force the fouls. Very deliberate play they need now, but having difficulty getting the ball inside.
They are indeed. Cunningham, Bird marking Cunningham at the moment. It's going to be a foul in a moment. 1 second before the shot went up, and it's gone in, and that, with 1 second to go, some sighs of relief on that Worthing bench, I can tell you. 59-52, and it's looking ominous. 3:12 to go. Guildford in disarray, and another steal, and Cadle needs a timeout, and he's called it. Harried makes Guildford pay. Now, this will be a real test for Kevin Cadle and the Guildford Kings, and that was the turnover, and Harried, the executioner, in the most emphatic way. The crowd thoroughly immersed in this final. Brilliant performance by Worthing, particularly in the last two quarters.
Everybody
in the second
to
half.
To the basketball and get some steals and work. We don't want to get caught up. We can't give them layups. All right? We can't give them layups. Hey, now listen here. It's 3 minutes left. All right? 3 minutes left. That means at least six possessions. All right? At least six possessions. So it's no problem. That means we just got to extend ourselves and work on the defensive end. So you go back to Colin, you go back over to Cleveland. All right, come on, man. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. One, two, three. Be the best.
Excellent timeout from Kevin Cadle, settling his team down, telling them they have got plenty of time left, and they have. Each time they get possession, there's 30 seconds to elapse, so they have six possessions in this game, and that's enough to win this game if they can get the composure and find a shooter.
3 minutes to go, and that was a vital play for Guildford. Now the pressure defense comes on. The early pressure, they can't allow Worthing to get down inside too early. They've got to try and create the mistakes early on. Politi out on the top, defending on to Cleve Lewis. Lewis getting inside, Cunningham, there's a foul, it's against Politi, I think. It's his second.
And that's a significant foul because it's the seventh foul that Guildford have made in this half, and that means that any foul they make now, Worthing will go to the foul line for a one-on-one situation. That could be very significant at the end.
Well, Cunningham has hit 14 points, 7 from 14 is a 50% rating, but it was the timing of that shot, and it's 63-54. What's that? Nine points. And Bird can't get through. He draws a good foul, though, this time on Lewis.
10 white.
Yes, it is. That's number one.
A first foul.
Sideline ball.
And that's also significant because it's Worthing's 17th foul, and that gives Guildford an attacking opportunity, drawing fouls and going to the foul line.
So Bird again will know that. Brown, Bird. So Cummings coming through into high position. Bird takes a shot. Oh, and that was an important shot. It's a big three, too, just outside the arc. So Alton Bird brings them back in. So 6 points down, his total of 10, 2 minutes and six to go. And for Worthing, this is an important attack too. The intensity of the Guildford defence for you to see. Not allowing Cunningham down the baseline or attempting not to, and that the big man got there. Lewis and Bird. And there's a foul. Now, who's it on? Cool and calm. That's against Alton Bird. It's Alton Bird. Will Jones just coolly and calmly moves across and signals a foul on this fella. It's a 1-1. And it's 1:48 to go, 63 to Worthing, 57 to Guildford. And Worthing in very, very good position indeed.
Key shot this, because after 17 fouls you get one shot and then a bonus shot. And Cleve Lewis, having made the first, gets the bonus of the second.
I tell you what, Martin Henlon scraped himself off the deck there, the big number 13 to the right of your shot. He looks very, very tired indeed. He looks absolutely spent. He's been well played in this final. He certainly has. He hasn't had the freedom. Spade looking anxiously on the left of his shot. There's another anxious look too from Kevin Cadle. Well, that was a vital success, wasn't it? Bird. Now, what can he do? He knows that they've got to have some three-point shots here. The man who can hit them is out there attempting. It's short, though, and the rebound's gone. And Worthing now very much in the driving seat. They sure are. Harried is a foul. On the way in, Harried. And the foul against Julio Politi. It's his third. Harried, the man advancing to the basket. So, 1 minute and 34 seconds left in this Budweiser final. 65-57, Worthing lead. They were behind all the way until the latter stages of the third quarter. They performed brilliantly in the third quarter. And now they're dominating the fourth at the moment. The score, remember, at the end of the third quarter, 45-43 to Guildford. But that's all changed now. 14 points to Harried, and I must say, Bill, that looking at his statistics, he's got a dozen rebounds, he's got a dozen points, 14 points now. He might well be the MVP for this.
Well, it's quite likely to come from the Worthing team. They've really dominated this final quarter, and Henlon there struggling to make a turnaround hook shot. It's a difficult shot at the best of times at this stage of the game. Just shows the frustration that the Guildford team are feeling.
Well, think, says Cunningham. 39 minutes, the big man on court. Now, that's 67-60 with that shot. Bird then hitting that three-pointer, three out of five, and with just 7 points down, 1 minute and one to go. It's still open, you know, a couple of three-pointers here and there. But Worthing with the opportunity now from the free throw line.
So there's Colin Irish taking very important shots from the foul line. Most valuable player, and he demonstrates why. Composure, making his points in the key moments of the game. All that's left for Guildford now is to run the ball down, take early shots, pressure, foul, put Worthing on the foul line, hope to miss it, regain possession for the rebounds.
Well, we gave the most valuable award to Herman Harried. I don't think he was too far behind that. So we've got a foul against 8 points with 55 seconds left, and it's looking very, very ominous indeed. And Alton Bird, a grimace on that face, moves to the line, and these are most important. Another little look up there from Cleve Lewis. These are important moments. Remember the Worthing Bears, the defending champions. And Alton Bird at the helm of this Guildford side that began with so much hope at the beginning of this season. He got into the European Big 16, didn't win a game in that, and had indifferent form in the league too, coming were fourth overall. Worthing was second. And now with 54 seconds left, the foul committed by Henlon to take his opponents down to the free throw line and to stop the clock.
Quite clever play by Guildford. They allowed Nelson to get the ball and fouled him on the basis that he is the player most likely to miss the foul shots.
Well, these are his first foul shots too, so not a best time in the world to have them either. So it was a good foul, wasn't it? Well, you heard that probably in the background, Alan Cunningham committing that foul and creating a one-on-one. That was a very useful play, wasn't it? The shot being missed, the first part of the one-on-one, and then the foul going against Cunningham, giving Henlon and Guildford another chance. And it really is another chance, because if he hits here, then, well, he's got to hit this first one to get the second, remember? Oh, he's got it. So a couple of three-pointers only. There's still 52 seconds. Surely Worthing aren't going to let this slip now.
Very important who Worthing get the ball to after this foul shot.
That was deliberate. He looked to get the rebound off that, I'm sure. Now, Harried in there. Oh, that's a deliberate foul called, and it was indeed. Alan Richardson had no alternative. And Carl Miller just completely surrounded his man, if that's possible, grasped him, and that's a deliberate foul, and that is a very big call. And actually, at the end of games, referees seldom call the deliberate foul, but that was absolutely deliberate, and Alan Richardson perfectly right in calling it. 68-63, Worthing over Guildford with just 43 seconds left, so the two free shots plus possession is a very, very hard call. But Steve Nelson, can you make full use of it? Got that one. That was very, very important. So it's 69-63. 6 points between them, still 43 seconds, but Worthing with the possession. Polity trying to slow down Lewis. Cunningham and Irish. Now they're playing the clock down, running the clock down now. There's another foul. It's bound to happen. We're into one-on-one situations all the time now. Taking their opponents to the shot line, because once that whistle blows, of course, the clock is stopped. 29 seconds left, 69-63.
We get something going to the bucket. Y'all two spotting up on the three-point line. We got something going to the bucket. If we get it, then as soon as the ball comes in, I want y'all to try to get a double and a reach and foul. We can't use up too much time on the clock each time. All right? All right, so we got to get something going to the bucket. We don't. Y'all spotting up for the trades. Then we got to go after the ball. We don't need an intentional foul. Just give me a hard reaching foul. That'll take them out of there. Come on, man. We all right. Let's go. Block out. One, two, three. Be the best.
As always, Kevin Cadle inspirational, and he needs to be at this stage. It's all about the rebound. It's about three-point shooting. But it can be done. The great thing about basketball is that we have seen teams come back from this deficit and win major championships. So everything to play for Guildford.
Henlon, Polity out there, Cummings, Miller, Bird, and the big man on the line, Alan Cunningham, 39 years old, 6'7", the mentor, the coach, the captain, and that is what a man in that sort of position should do. 70-63. 16 points if he scores this one. He does, and that's a big score. And now three-pointers have got to fly from all angles, that's for sure. And the rebound has to be taken as well. Henlon has got inside and got 2 points. Well, it's 71 now, 65 with just 17 seconds, and Worthing on their way, surely. The full-court press on, but with just 9 seconds left. And we've got a foul. They've taken them to the line again. 8 seconds left. 71 to Worthing, 65 to Guildford. And Worthing surely, surely on their way to retaining their title they won for the first time last season. second in the league, and their support here of every cause for celebration.
Ladies and gentlemen, stay with us for the
this
final,
is an important shot, of course, just to put the nail in. Bird has it. Now, can he hit a three-pointer and upset things? He's got to try. Misses this time, and that's the rebound that wins the title for Worthing. Worthing are the Budweiser champions for the second year running. A marvellous performance all round, really. Colin Irish adjudged the most valuable player, but what a game Herman Harrod had. And this man, Alan Cunningham, the coach, the captain, 39 years old, led his team with such style. And his support, well, they've got their just reward. It's been a marvellous performance. For the first half, it looked as though Guildford were in the ascendancy, and then Worthing came back to win the third quarter, and then the fourth quarter, they looked very much the stronger of the two teams. The final score then, Worthing 71, Guildford 65. Worthing are the champions for 1994.
And the commentators for that final were Stuart Story and Brian Beswick. Well, while the Worthing Bears were celebrating, there was just a touch of sadness as Alan Cunningham announced his retirement as a player, but he will stay on to influence the Worthing team as their coach next season. But he certainly has been a dominant force in British basketball. Well, from one dominant force in sport to another, and a man making a welcome return to form. I only really need to say one name, Seve, and you know exactly which sport I'm referring to. So we're now going live to the St Melian Golf Course in Cornwall.